The word cancer is alarming. However, more research is being conducted every day, and we gain more insight into this deadly disease. Cancer is a disease in which your cells grow out of control and spread to other body regions. There are more than 100 different types of cancer, and it can occur anywhere in the body. Because cancer can take many different shapes and forms, it's always named after the location where it first appears. When cancer spreads from the esophagus to the liver, it's referred to as esophageal cancer and can never be known as liver cancer. So, in today's video, we'll be discussing the signs and symptoms of esophageal cancer. Let's get started. Esophageal cancer is a type of cancer that develops in the esophagus, which is a long, hollow tube that connects your throat to your stomach. Your esophagus aids in the movement of food from the back of your throat to your stomach for digestion. Esophageal cancer can develop at any point along the esophagus. Esophageal cancer affects more men than women. Usually, the cells that line the interior of the esophagus are where cancer develops. The esophageal wall is composed of several layers of tissue, including the mucous membrane, muscle, and connective tissue. As it grows, esophageal cancer begins on the inside lining of the esophagus and spreads outward through the other layers. Studies reveal the seventh most frequent cause of cancer-related fatalities globally is esophageal cancer. Varying geographic regions have different incidence rates. Before we get into the signs and symptoms, let's understand how to determine if we have this dreadful disease. Let's look into its causes. The exact cause of esophageal cancer is unknown. Esophageal cancer develops when cells in the esophagus develop changes in their DNA. Cells grow and divide out of control as a result of the changes. The accumulating abnormal cells in the esophagus form a tumor, which can invade nearby structures and spread to other parts of the body. However, they identified risk factors that increase the likelihood of development, such as tobacco use. This includes both smoking and the use of smokeless tobacco. Obesity. Being overweight or obese can cause esophageal inflammation, leading to cancer. Alcoholism. Chronic or heavy alcohol use increases the risk of esophageal cancer. Barrett's esophagus and chronic acid reflux. Barrett's esophagus is a change in the cells at the bottom of your esophagus caused by untreated chronic acid reflux. Esophageal cancer and gastroesophageal reflux have a significant and likely causative relationship. People with chronic heartburn have a higher risk of esophageal cancer, even if they don't have Barrett's esophagus. Other diseases. Esophageal cancer has been linked to several rare and inherited diseases. One is achalasia, a rare disease that makes swallowing difficult. Tylosis is another disorder that causes excess skin to grow on the palms of your hands and soles of your feet. People who have had neck or head cancer are more likely to develop esophageal cancer. Occupational exposure to certain chemicals. People exposed to dry cleaning solvents, carpenters, electricians, bartenders, miners, shotgunners, stone cutters, and sculptors for an extended time are at a higher risk of developing esophageal cancer. Hot liquids or radiation. It's been observed that a consistent habit of drinking scalding liquids or undergoing radiation treatment to the chest or upper abdomen may result in esophageal cancer as well. There could be several types of esophageal cancer. There are several types of esophageal cancer. Esophageal cancer is classified based on the types of cells involved. Your treatment options are influenced by the type of esophageal cancer you have. Adenocarcinoma. Adenocarcinoma begins in the cells of the esophageal mucus-secreting glands. Adenocarcinoma most commonly develops in the lower esophagus. The most common type of esophageal cancer in the United States is adenocarcinoma, which primarily affects white men. Squamous cell carcinoma. This is a cancer of the squamous cells. Squamous cells are flat, thin cells that line the esophageal surface. Squamous cell carcinoma occurs in the upper and middle esophagus and is the most common type of esophageal cancer in the world. Other uncommon types. These include small cell carcinoma, sarcoma, lymphoma, melanoma, and karyocarcinoma, which are all classified as rare types of esophageal cancer. Do you want to build a strong immune system? Consider Sambucus Elderberry Immune Support. This product supports your immune health daily by providing high-potency vitamin C and D, as well as an excellent source of zinc. Sambucus gummies contain a highly concentrated black elderberry extract with a serving size of 3,200 milligrams of elderberry. Elderberries contain anthocyanins, which are naturally occurring antioxidants. Antioxidants aid the neutralization of free radicals. Elderberries have been used for centuries to support the immune system. You may make them a daily part of your routine to help you feel best. Signs and symptoms. Now, let's talk about the symptoms and signs that people with esophageal cancer may experience. A symptom, such as fatigue, nausea, or pain, is something that only the person experiencing it can identify and describe. A sign is something that others can detect and quantify, such as fever, rash, or elevated pulse. Signs and symptoms, when combined, can help describe a medical problem. Difficulty in swallowing. The most significant sign that esophageal cancer patients experience is dysphagia. Dysphagia is a common medical term for difficulty swallowing and related pain while eating, especially when eating meat or any hard, dry substance, bread, or raw vegetable. As the tumor grows, it can potentially obstruct the path to your stomach. Even liquids can be difficult to swallow. As your esophagus narrows due to the growing of the cancer, your symptoms will gradually worsen, with an increase in pain when swallowing. Chronic chest pain. If you have chronic heartburn or gastroesophageal reflux disease, you are already familiar with burning pain in the center of your chest. When esophageal cancer develops, that painful sensation may become more noticeable. Studies have revealed that the most common symptom is chest pain, which can be difficult for doctors to identify from cardiac pain because they're so similar. When food or liquid reaches the site of the tumor in the esophagus, esophageal cancer can cause chest pain a few seconds after swallowing. There could be chest pressure or burning sensation, while some patients have reported feeling heartburn or indigestion. Weight loss. About 50% of esophageal cancer patients have unexplained weight loss. This may result from eating less due to swallowing issues or a loss of appetite brought on by cancer. However, as cancer spreads and at a later stage, about 60% to 85% of esophageal cancer patients may experience weight loss before surgery. The most prevalent reasons for weight loss include dysphagia, reduced oral intake, systemic inflammation, and mental health issues. Hoarseness or persistent coughing. A persistent cough or a hoarse, scratchy voice may also indicate esophageal cancer. As an esophageal tumor advances, it may harm laryngeal nerves and interfere with brain impulses that travel to the voice box, paralyzing the voice cords. Laryngeal nerve palsy is a disorder that can occasionally cause the vocal cord nerves to stop functioning entirely. One of the typical signs of locally progressed thoracic esophageal squamous cell carcinoma is hoarseness, which is caused by recurrent laryngeal nerve palsy, which can be brought on by nodal metastasis along with recurrent laryngeal nerve or by primary tumors. Many people with esophageal cancer may not exhibit any of the signs and symptoms we just have covered. Alternatively, the symptoms or warnings could be of another medical condition other than cancer. Symptom relief is integral to cancer care and treatment if cancer is discovered. This is known as palliative care or supportive care. It's frequently initiated shortly after diagnosis and continues throughout treatment. So, how is esophageal cancer diagnosed? Esophageal cancer could relate to some of the typical symptoms that we've just discussed. If any of these symptoms persist, your doctor will ask you health-related questions and use examinations and tests to determine what's causing your symptoms. We will now go over some of the most common tests used to determine whether or not you have this dreadful disease. Barium swallow. This is sometimes the first test performed on patients who have difficulty swallowing. It's a series of x-rays taken after you swallow barium, a thick, chalky liquid that appears on x-rays. The x-ray reveals any lumps on the inner lining of the esophagus. Barium meal radiography is a reliable imaging method for preoperative diagnosis because it clearly shows the imaging characteristics of esophageal cancer. Upper endoscopy. A flexible, thin tube with a tiny light and a video camera on the end is inserted into your mouth and passed down through your esophagus to your stomach to perform this test. If there are any suspicious spots, a small piece of tissue can be removed through the tube and tested for cancer. Endoscopic ultrasonography is used to determine the depth of cancer infiltration. Barrett's esophagus endoscopic surveillance has become a cornerstone of esophageal cancer management. CT scan. This is very commonly known as a CAT scan. It's similar to an X-ray, but the images are more detailed. This can reveal the location of the cancer in the esophagus and whether it's spread. CT scans can also be used to assist with a biopsy. Imaging techniques like a positron emission tomography, also known as CT scans or computerized tomography, provide crucial details about the local scope and potential spread of the disease, which in turn aid in choosing the best course of treatment for these patients. Additionally, it contributes to the analysis of esophageal cancer for a better evaluation process. MRI scan. Instead of X-rays, MRI scans use radio waves and powerful magnets to create detailed images. Doctors may use it to determine whether nearby lymph nodes are swollen, indicating that cancer spread there. MRI can detect esophageal carcinoma with high sensitivity, but low specificity. This technique holds promise for evaluating neoadjuvant therapy's efficacy and identifying locally progressed diseases for trimodality treatment. PET scans. PET scans use a type of sugar that can be seen inside your body using a special camera. If cancer exists, this sugar appears as hot spots where the cancer is found. It can help determine whether cancer has spread. The T staging of esophageal cancer and the detection of spread to local regional lymph nodes are both limited applications for PET imaging. However, PET scans enable the diagnosis of metastatic disease that might not be discernible with other techniques. For determining the therapy process in the primary tumor in a given patient, PET scans have not shown promising results. Biopsy. During a biopsy, the doctor removes a small piece of tissue from the area where cancer appears. A biopsy is the only way to determine whether or not you have cancer. To confirm the endoscopist's diagnosis, areas can undergo targeted biopsies. Because when many samples are required, the sensitivity of mucosal biopsies to identify esophageal cancer is 96%. A biopsy for esophageal cancer is usually performed along with an endoscopy. Gene and protein tests. Cancer cells from biopsy tissues could be tested for genes or proteins like HER2, PD-L1, MMR, and MSI. Knowing which genes or proteins are present in your cancer can help your doctor determine whether treatments such as targeted therapy or immunotherapy may be beneficial. Recently, researchers conducted a thorough investigation of molecular changes present in esophageal cancer. Furthermore, methods of exome and whole genome sequencing uncovered certain recurrent genetic events that are drivers of esophageal cancer and provided evidence that the genetic aberrations are quite complicated. This analysis revealed that the frequency of mutations and the type of cancer was high, second only to that found in melanoma and lung cancer. This crucial finding implies that these tumors are exposed to and derived from the effects of various harmful agents, supported also by the peculiar environment produced by gastric reflux and chronic inflammation. Good dietary habits and supplementing yourself with necessary vitamins, minerals, and nutrients are needed to keep diseases like cancer at bay. Let's keep the conversation going with a few more videos on cancer, shall we? Watch 7 Most Deadliest Cancers, or 8 Common Cancer Signs That Are Almost Always Ignored. Go ahead and click one, or even better, watch both videos to learn about cancer. Did any symptoms shock you? Let us know in the comments below.